Okay guys, so we got our otter here. We're gonna flash him here quick. And basically we got him set up on a beam. He's been in the refrigerator overnight. He's nice and cold. We got him turned kind of sideways with his arms facing here. And we're just gonna start here with our sharp side. Just below the ear. Just to kind of get the fat rolling here. Gonna work him down a little ways. Otters kind of have, they've got a unique kind of fat on them. It's a hard fat, not real greasy kind. So, for me anyways, I'd rather just go real easy and use the sharp side of my knife rather than using the dull side and taking a chance of singeing the hair. We only want to go over the area just a limited amount of times to reduce any chance of singeing. Around the arms here, we're just going to kind of push a little bit just to kind of get the fat rolling here. We don't want to cut a hole in our pelt here. You know, otters, they're kind of up there as far as worthwhile pelts. They pretty much command a good price, even in low markets. Just dress up here a little bit, staying in our comfort zone here. We'll just take him and we'll turn him there and roll him. And we'll come back up to the top here and start right back down. You could almost compare the fat to somewhat like a beaver, just kind of clings on a little bit more so than a beaver. Once again, we get down to the arms. Push a little of that off. Trying to be easy. Where we don't singe the hair. Working him down. Below the arm there. There, we can get that fat rolling. Now we'll turn to the back side. You're not going to be able to get all the fat. I mean, not all of it, but they will melt pretty good. They'll melt like a beaver. So just get the majority. Turn him around to his neck here. Just work it down. Like so. See, I'm just working the fat back and forth with my sharp side. Pull them up. I use my clamp this time just to reset. And we'll start back again. Otters have fairly thick skin. Just kind of push that membrane out of the way. And just real easily go over with our sharp side. Just clean up last little bit. Take them and roll them again. At this point, we kind of stick the arm holes into our flushing beam. Kind of dress up around that area. Coming down below the arms. If you're working with a female, you want to watch out the nipples. Roll him over there to his other arm. You can see I'm just kind of rotating back and forth between my sharp side and my dull side. No hurry whatsoever. We're just scraping him down. Otters are primarily pretty good size, so I mean you got a lot to work with here. Like I said, I just find a little easier to work with that sharp side, just because that fat binds that skin so well. Working them down here, just keep rolling them. You can see I'm staying right here in my comfort zone. Not getting extended out. Not pulling the hide, going all the way down and then pulling the hide back over meat. You're just rolling them. Easiest way to save yourself from getting something underneath the hide. Again, working that membrane down, and then that fat underneath that comes right off with the sharp side. Roll them again here. Reposition our clamp. down towards the bottom here. We'll get rid of a bunch of them fleshings there. I need to have to work around those. Keeping our beam clean here. If you get some stuff on your beam, take you a couple seconds. Have your rag there. Wipe it off. Reposition here. Okay, right there, this is a male. It's the penis hole there. Just take and work right around that. Okay, whenever we skin that, that's pretty much where his balls were held, so that'll be cut off, so we're not going to worry too much about that. And just finish off. Around here. Okay, now that's everything besides the tail. We'll wipe our beam off. Now the tail of an otter, you're gonna have to use your sharp side. You can't push it. There's basically two tubes right here that run down the side, and you've gotta use your sharp side to get all that fat out of there. The best way to do it is take your sharp side and work at an angle this way and then this way, and then you can come back and get the middle. But if you work everything down together, it's a lot easier than trying to go down one side and then the other. So we'll just center them up a little bit here. You can see it rolls out in kind of a windrow type look to it. Come over here to this side. Like I said, we'll work everything down together using our sharp side. Otters are one critter that you need to keep the tail on them. They'll use that tail. So we'll just keep working it down here. You end up with just a little bit there. They're on the edge. Don't fight it. Don't take a chance of cutting. Once you get them on the board, you can just finish that little bit off. Like I said, just work one side, come out, and we'll come back, get the middle. Push a little of that off. Getting down towards the bottom of it there. Just work real easy with your knife. Because as you can see, because there's two tubes in there, as you flesh, the tail is actually going to separate and open up. So you don't want to get too carried away where you get pushing through there and you end up cutting the skin. So anyway, we've got all the way down to the end. You can see that skin all the way down. We've got just a little bit hanging on here. That's no big deal. We'll just take our knife once he's on the board and just get that right off. So anyway, that's our fleshed otter. He's good to go now. We'll put him on the board here, and that'll be part 3. So thank you, guys.